Welcome to VidPT. Today we're going to discuss IT band syndrome. That's right, iliotibial band syndrome, which is the most common cause of lateral knee pain in runners. We'll start with some basic anatomy, discuss some common signs and symptoms associated with IT band syndrome, and conclude with how to strengthen key areas of the body to combat it. Now, IT band syndrome is a very common overuse or wear and tear injury. It typically targets runners, cyclists, CrossFitters, and other athletes that squat often. The IT band tends to get overworked as a result of muscle imbalances or potential muscle deficiencies in the body. Consequently, you get pain on the outside part of the hip, you can get myofascial restrictions all along the outer part of the leg, and you can experience sharp pain on the outside part of the knee where the IT band rubs over the femoral epicondyle. The primary function of the IT band and its associated muscles to extend, abduct, and laterally rotate the hip. Additionally, the IT band contributes to lateral knee stabilization by connecting the muscles of the hip to the tibia of the lower leg. In terms of anatomy, the IT band starts up at the hip. You have up here, you have, it's called the iliac crest. Off of the iliac crest, you have a short strap-like muscle. It's called the TFL. The IT band runs off the TFL. It gets a contribution from the gluteus maximus, and then it runs down the length of the thigh, runs down the iliotibial tract, or the IT band, right? So just look at the stripe. It goes down the stripe all the way, crosses over the knee joint, the outside part of the knee, across the lateral femoral epicondyle, and then it inserts itself down below onto the anterior side of the tibia. So another way to think of the IT band, it's really a continuation, right? It's a continuation of the tendinous portion of the TFL, and there's a contribution, a small contribution, from the gluteus maximus. All right, so we're about to go in the weeds, and I promise there's a key takeaway. So this iliotibial tract, right, runs down the length of the thigh, is classified as deep fascia. There are all different types of fascia in the body. In general, fascia is terribly important and is incredibly fascinating since it surrounds and connects muscles of the body to other tissues. This fascia is comprised or classified as deep fascia, right? It's composed of very strong connective tissue. This tissue is primarily composed of collagen and fibroblast cells. There are a few elastin fibers in there, but it's very strong. And as many of you know, collagen is one of the strongest proteins, right, you can find in nature, and is one of the strongest structures in the human body. Consequently, the IT band is, right, it's strong, it's tough, and it's relatively inelastic. So what does this mean? Well, it impacts your stretching routine. So many physical therapists and trainers promote stretching the IT band. In practice, it's incredibly difficult to do so just based on the sheer composition of the IT band. Consequently, I found it's much more effective to stretch the surrounding areas, right? You stretch your glutes, it's good to get in your glutes, you get into the hips, you stretch your hamstrings, you can stretch the outer part of your thigh, you can stretch your calves. Additionally, you can get into, right, you can get into your hip flexors and your psoas. For you stretching masochists out there, there's some of you that absolutely love the foam roller. Here's a substitute. This is a tennis ball. You can go to town with a tennis ball, right? You lie on your back, you can get in your gluteus maximus, you can get into the medius. It's really hard to get into the minimus since it goes under the other structures, but you can get into your glutes, you can get into your hips, you can get into the TFL, right? You can really start to loosen a lot of the lateral gluteal muscles. You want to get into the hip flexors and psoas, I recommend a larger, softer ball. Okay, this doesn't have a lot of give, so use a larger, softer ball when you're lying on your front. But the tennis ball is terrific. You can get in a lot of places and get some of the strain and tension out there and help the IT band move more freely and to have less pain. For your runners out there, it's really important to stretch your calves as well. So I mentioned stretching your calves, but there's two main muscles, right? You have the gastrocnemius and you have the soleus. You need to stretch both. If you're already having pain on the outside part of the knee and you have tight calves, it can lead to greater pronation when you run. So it changes the way your foot strikes the ground, right? The way you're putting energy into the ground, the way it's coming back, and it can increase knee flexion. So if you have greater knee flexion, you're gonna exacerbate the pain on the outside part of your knee. So what are some common signs and symptoms associated with IT band syndrome? Right, most people get pain on the outside part of the knee. Typically it starts as kind of a needle prick. I've had it several times. It's where you get needle pricks in the outside part of the knee. You continue to heel strike, you go up and down stairs, you carry heavy things. Then moves up the leg, you get myofascial restrictions, and then it goes into the hip. So when it's onset, it's really typically the knee and the hip. So how do we fix it, right? That's why you're here today. How do we fix IT band syndrome? Research studies out of Stanford University have shown that IT band syndrome is correlated or attributable to weakness in the hips and glutes. Your glutes are comprised of three key muscles, right? You have the gluteus maximus, which everyone loves to talk about. You have the medius and minimus. The medius and minimus are primarily responsible for balance. And when you run or cycle, you need to have good balance and proper body mechanics. If you're weak in the hips and glutes, your body will compensate. Your body's amazing at compensating, right? So if you're weak in the gluteus, medius, and minimus, your IT band's gonna pick up the slack. Additionally, get tight in the hip flexors and likely your psoas. Now, some people talk about a pelvic tilt. Can you get a pelvic tilt? Yes, but just because your medius and minimus are weak doesn't mean your pelvis has to tilt. So the goal, if you stretch the gluteus, medius, and minimus, right, you strengthen those areas and stretch, you can take some pain and strain off of the IT band. The following routine that I've put together focuses on strengthening the lateral gluteal muscles. These are comprised of the TFL, gluteus medius, and the gluteus minimus. Additionally, I've provided stretches, right? I provide stretches you don't see all the time. And with those stretches at the back of each routine, I give you options. So if that stretch doesn't work for you, pick another. There are tons of great stretches out there. And you'll also notice that the exercise I provide, there's pretty much basic to medium to advanced. And you need to pick the ones that work for you. Your body will gravitate to ones that work, and you'll start to move forward. Now, if you're in a great deal of pain, then it's really important that you stop running or cycling. Continuing to pound the pavement or bang on the pedals make the injury more pronounced and lengthen the duration of your rehabilitation. So what are other activities you can do? Get in the pool. Swimming's great. However, in swimming, be mindful of your flip turns, right? Don't do really deep walls. You don't necessarily have to fire off the wall. So swimming's great. If it puts strain on the legs, you can also use a pole buoy to mitigate some of the strain. So I know we've covered a lot of ground today, right? We've discussed what is IT band syndrome, what are signs and symptoms, and how do we strengthen the key areas of the body to combat it. Thank you very much for your time. I've enjoyed the discussion, and I look forward to working across the routine that I've put together.